Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. So last class we have taken what do you mean by physical and chemical changes. Okay. Irene, tell me what do you mean by physical changes? Physical changes.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you mean by physical change, Irene? Tell me. Say in your own words. Physical change means what?
And physical change is a change in which new substance is formed.
Okay. It is a change in which no new substance is formed. Chapter 6, Jennifer. Okay. Jennifer, I think you can sit there because I am covering the board, no? You sit here. You can shift to my book and you can sit here. Don't fall. Then keep it on that table. Because you may not see because I am standing like this, no? So that's it. Okay. Alisha, give some examples for physical change.
Melting of ice, cutting of wood.
Abel, what was your seminar?
Functions
of heart only, no? Okay, tomorrow we can have that. Clear? Get ready with it. Okay. So we continue with this. What is the example for Badi? Give an example for a physical change. Physical change example.
Ma'am, melting an ice.
Melting an ice. Anything else apart from this? So many things what happen in our life, physical change.
Breaking egg. Okay.
Fatima, what do you mean by chemical change?
A chemical change is a change when new substance is formed.
Okay, when new substance is formed. Okay, give an example of a chemical change.
Ma'am, fireworks.
Okay, fireworks is a chemical change. Okay. Pranav, can you give me the properties of a physical change?
Yes, ma'am.
Give the properties of a physical change.
Ma'am, firing a paper.
Firing a paper.
Hello, I told properties of physical change, Pranav. Property, when a physical change, what are the things can be changed? That is the property. What's that?
Shape
is changing. Okay, anything. Aaron, can you tell me properties of physical change?
Yes, ma'am.
What are the which are the properties of physical change?
Ma'am, physical change, no new product is formed.
Okay.
And the examples are melting of ice.
Okay.
Cutting of paper.
Okay. And what else can change? What else can change?
This shape and size.
Shape and size also can be changed. Okay. There's one more point I have given. Another point. Physical change can be
classified into two types, reversible and irreversible.
Reversible or irreversible. Okay, Abel, what do you mean by reversible, Abel?
Can change.
Huh?
Which can change.
Which can change and then what will happen? After changing, reversible. What do you mean
by? It can change your original position.
Original position. After one change, it can return back to it. Okay. Rehan, can you give an example for a reversible change in your own words? Something we can do it and we can return back. Something, in 6th standard also you must have studied. Majority, all the videos are off. Naim, what is this? Safa, Naim, Nihal, Pranav, everyone switch on the video.
Ma'am, can I?
Okay, Paul Hansel, say.
Ma'am.
One change happen, it can return back.
Folding the paper.
Folding the paper. Once you fold the paper, afterwards you can make it straight. Okay, anything? One more example.
Boiling of water.
Boiling of water. Once it boiled, it get evaporated and then It can condense and go back. Correct. Okay. Anything more?
Ma'am, melting of ice.
Melting of ice or melting of ice cream, melting of fat. Everything is a reversible. Which is not irreversible is irreversible. Can you give an example of irreversible physical change?
Wait,
Aaron. Safwan, can you give an example of an irreversible physical change?
Ma'am.
Irreversible means once the change happens, it cannot return back. So many examples.
Ma'am, milk.
Milk, what will happen? Milk, tell me. Simply milk, you don't say. Tell me.
Ma'am, in milk, when we add cocoa powder, tea powder, it we can no substitute.
That is true. That's a chemical change. Okay. I want physical change which is irreversible. Physical means change, size or something changes.
Yes.
Ma'am,
it become boil. Ma'am, it become boil.
In become boiled, that's a okay. Become boiled after boiled or irreversible. Okay, let us go to Nihal. Give me example.
Ma'am, cutting of paper.
Paper cutting, paper tearing the paper, chopping the wood. Once your wood cut into pieces, will it return back to original position?
No.
So no, it's a physical change, but boiling. That is chemical change. I'm talking chemical physical change. Physical change means changing the shape or size or of anything. Tearing the paper, tearing the cloth. Okay, it's a irreversible change. It is a irreversible change. And reversible change means stretching a rubber band, folding in the paper, then crushing the paper. After crushing the paper, you can raise it. You can make it.
Erasing a rubber.
Erasing a rubber. Rubber.
It is erasable, ma'am.
It is erasable. That is reversible, no? If you write with the pencil.
That erase things.
If you are writing ballpoint pen, if you write it with the pencil, it is reversible. If you write it with a ballpoint pen, it is irreversible. Okay. So that's it. Yeah. So shall we now continue with the lesson? So we have completed that much, I think. Did we discuss the chemical changes? Yes, so I think it's all over. So properties of physical change is over. Did we discuss the properties of chemical change last class?
Yes.
Yeah.
So what is the properties of chemical changes? This is known as properties of chemical changes. Fatima, can you read which I picked?
During a chemical change, the following changes take place. Formation of new substances. Heat or light may be absorbed or released. Sound may be produced. A color change may take place. A change is smell may take place. A gas may
be formed. Okay. Formation of the new substance means milk is turning to a curd, becoming curd. One example. Can you give me another example? Formation of new substances.
Fireworks.
Fireworks. Okay, formation of the new substance. You will get fireworks. It is a new substance. After burning, you will get a ashes. Okay. Heat or light may be absorbed or released.
Talk about.
Apart from fireworks, any other example can you give me? Heat or light may be absorbed or released. You mean another example instead of fireworks? Anyone?
I'm lighting candle.
Lighting candle. Very good. Lighting a candle. So this is also is a chemical change. Lighting a candle. So heat energy and light energy also. Sound may be produced. Which is the one? Sound may be produced.
Firework.
Firework. Okay. Anything else? Instead of firework, sound can be produced.
Speaker.
Speaker. it's electrical energy, no? Okay, so that okay, is a conversion of energy. Another thing we can write about what you call whistle of cooker, correct? Cooker whistle. So when the food is cooked or channa is cooked, it will produce the whistle. Clear? Okay. Another thing, explosion, bomb explosion. That is also is a chemical change. Bomb explosion. Then fizzing. When you open the soda bottle, have you heard some sound? Fizzing sound. Yeah. that's it. Coca-Cola and this and all, when you open, you can see fizzing sound will come. Color change. Can you give an example? Color change.
Color in a water.
Oh,
putting the, if you mix with the color in the water.
Paint
also. Very good. Paint is another chemical reaction. Luminous. Making of luminous paper. Making of different colors paper. All these are chemical change. What about the smell?
Ma'am, when the food is spoiled.
Spoiled food. And when the egg
is spoiled. Pollution.
Pollution. The plastic. When the burning of plastic. Burning of plastic. This also produces a toxins and you will get a smell. A gas may be formed. Making cool drinks. Yeah, Coca-Cola and all. It is also gas. And also burning the plastic. You see, burning the plastic, yes, you will get a carbon monoxide produced.
I'm burning plastic bottle.
Plastic material and vinegar and baking soda mixing. Vinegar and baking soda mixing, that is the time also you will get. Okay, children, so these are the different properties of chemical. Yes. Now we are moving on to the different way of difference between physical and chemical change. Okay. Yes. Yes. Naeem, can you read physical change? All of you, please write down the difference between physical change and chemical change. Number one, number two, number three. Copy down, all of you. Naeem, read.
Physical change.
Changes are?
Physical changes are mostly reversible.
Okay.
No new substance.
Okay. Then corresponding difference in chemical change?
Chemical changes are not reversible.
Okay, good. Next point, next difference.
In physical change, no new substances are formed. And in chemical change, one or more new substances are formed.
Okay.
Physical.
Third difference.
The substance retains its chemical properties. The new substances formed have different properties from the original substance.
Okay, children. Okay. So these are the three differences here. Physical changes reversible. The chemical changes are not reversible. No new substance are formed. One or more new substances are formed. The substance retains its chemical property. What do you mean by retain its chemical property? Because you see, whenever you chop the wood may turn into pieces, but it remains its own wood. So that's why it retains its chemical properties. But melting of, burning of paper. Burning of the paper, it turns into ashes. So it is having a different properties. So that is the difference between them. This thing don't write, only that 3 points you can write down now. The difference between physical and chemical changes. So children, tomorrow also 7B, you are having class at 9:10 on this board. Don't forget. All those are sleeping, wake up early and come to the class. Okay.
Ma'am, today only one class is
there. Yes, today you had only one class.
I think
check by 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock. Check by 9 o'clock. Your class group. If any change in the timetable, you will come to know. Otherwise, I will be putting the timetable for tomorrow. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
And from till Christmas holidays, you look into your group. Okay. So I will be sending the this one timetable every day. Don't look into the old timetable. Where 4:55 class and all. Okay. If it is there, I will be mentioned. Tomorrow we'll start with the ABLES seminar, that is HEART, and you are going to have a written class test on next Monday. Written class test on
next Monday. Which chapter?
The chapter 11, transportation. Because you have a lot of things to be studied. Learn the print. Learn the note what I have said. Okay. I will write the give you questions from that. Chapter 11, transportation written test. I'm giving 1 week to study. Study well. I know it is a lengthy chapter, but you have to study. Over?
I'm lost.
Okay, okay, no problem. Continue. Have you written differences between physical and chemical?
Yes.
Are there anyone is still writing?
Yes, ma'am. Finish.
Okay. Naeem, I have given you some semiconductor rusting and galvanization. Correct, Naeem, for seminar.
Yes.
Naeem, rusting and Safan is galvanization. Correct.
Hmm.
Tomorrow get ready for it, okay? Don't be absent. Morning session 9:10 class. After that only I can take the portion rusting and garner session after you present your seminar. Heard, Naeem and Safan?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Why is that? Yes is so feeble, Naeem. You are sure that you don't get up 9:10, correct?
Yeah.
You have to come, otherwise every chapter, now remaining 3 chapters, every chapter I'm going to make you to do the seminar, otherwise if you don't do it.
No, ma'am, I will come in tomorrow.
Okay, because I have to continue with the class with after your seminar, that's why. Okay, children, so I hope you have a test on Monday, that also don't forget. Okay, children, so this is what about the differences. And see, in chemical changes, apart from this burning and all, there are so many various processes involved in chemical changes. And these processes, we call it as a chemical reaction. The first process, so you can write the next heading, process involved. Process involved in, because in 8th and 9th, you are going to learn about more chemical reaction. Chemical reaction also known as a chemical change. Okay, so process involved in chemical change. Write the heading, process involved in chemical changes, or we call it chemical reaction. Chemical changes also we call it as chemical reaction. Okay, so the first process is fermentation. The first process inorganic chemical reaction is fermentation. Example of fermentation you can write, making dosa flour. Making dosa flour. You know, in fermentation means we put the urad dal into it, grind it and keep it for one full night. And then next day you see it is coming up. So this is fermentation. Second one is rusting. So that is Naim's portion. Rusting means change the color of iron. That is simply I can say, I'm not going much detail to rusting, that Naim will teach. Change the color of iron. And third process is explosion. Explosion mainly it happened bomb explosion. Sometimes a reaction between acid and base. So these are an example of explosion. Reaction between like a very powerful acid and base. If you put more vinegar and more baking soda, you increase the quantity of more baking soda and vinegar, you will able to see that maybe a lot of sound may come and even that plastic boat, whichever you make it, can explode if it is going to be more. So this is also involved in the case of chemical change. Fourth one, oxidation or oxidizing. Oxidizing, burning of magnesium. Burning of magnesium. This is another process which is involved in chemical reaction. All of you write this, then we go to the next four. Fermentation, rusting, explosion, oxidizing. I hope first one you have written. The next one, I am writing on the top. Fifth one, we are having corrosion. Corrosion. Corrosion means sometimes when you keep the tamarind in aluminium vessel, aluminium vessel will get spoiled. So some of the metallic vessels will get a black coating on that. That is known as corrosion. Changing color of metallic vessels. You see, Hindus know you all will be putting the oil in that nilavalakku, correct? And after some time, what do you see in the nilavalakku? One, what color will be there in that after some time if you don't clean it daily?
Ma'am, black color,
sometimes a greenish color also forms. So that is corrosion. Okay, that's also chemical reaction. So we need to clean the lamp continuously.
Ma'am, it is my topic.
Who is that?
I'm Safan, ma'am.
Safan, galvanization. And sixth point is tarnishing. Tarnishing means that also one way of, we can say it, the metallic vessels are getting spoiled. Tarnishing. So we can just spoiling metallic vessels. We cannot use. Sometimes there will be some holes and all in the aluminium vessels and some other color or fungus and all will be there. That is not tarnishing. Tarnishing, spoiling metallic vessels. That is also due to the chemical change. Then seventh one, burning. That's everyone knows, burning the paper. So burning is very common. The what will happen? Burning, it will turn into ashes. Okay. So the objects turn into ashes or gases. Like firework, when you burn the crackers, you can see afterwards it will turn into either gases or it turn into ashes. So that is burning. And last one is rotting. That is, you know, rotting of vegetable. The last process involved in this rotting. Example, you can say spoiling vegetables. Vegetables, food, the all food items. Very common. So rotting, burning, all this is very common. Corrosion underground will happen in some particular situations only. So usually our grandmother and all, they don't make the fish curry in the aluminium vessels because aluminium vessel gets spoiled due to reaction between tamarind or that citric acid is there, no? In mangoes and all things. It will react with the aluminium. So usually they make either in the mud vessels. Usually we now also we are using to make the fish curry in the mud vessel, mud pot, or we can use the steel vessel, but we can't use any other vessels to keep the tamarind or curd or something. You should never keep in the aluminium, either keep in the steel vessel or any other vessel. Okay, so see, these are the various processes involved in chemical changes. This corrosion and all you will be learning in higher classes more detail about it. Reaction, what is exact reaction in the corrosion happens, and there's a chemical equation and all. So we are not going to that much. Okay, children? Have you completed, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So we are coming to the winding of the classes now, the last session of today. The chemical reactions in everyday life, very common reactions we are having. One is photosynthesis, that is happening in our plants every day. Then cooking is a chemical reaction everyday life. And respiration, anaerobic and aerobic respiration, both are chemical changes. Then digestion of the food, and combustion means burning anything. Like lighting the candle, all those.
Mom, like in engines and stuff?
Huh?
Mom, like in engines, combustion.
Yes. Engines, the train. Train engine, car engine, all these. Car engine is moving because of there is a chemical reaction taking place in the petrol and diesel when it burns. Okay. So these are the some common chemical reaction in our everyday life. Photosynthesis and all. Okay, children, so I hope today I think more students are present. So tomorrow 9:10, need everyone should be present, okay? After so long, now it is 16 students, otherwise 10 students. You just see our total strength is 27. 10 students are still missing, and not 10, including Jennifer. Now we are having 17 students, okay? So 10 more students.
Mom, Ausepachan
came in the beginning, and I don't know.
He is here now.
Okay, children, I am now entering the session. So tomorrow, Naeem, Safan, and Abel, we can start your seminar, and then we continue our lessons. Okay? Thank you, children.
Yes.